had been ivory, not wildlife trafficking, but it is a wildlife product, the ivory. People would kill the elephants for the ivory. And was it around 2012 when we had the highest cases? But since that time, we have suppressed it. And now, we can comfortably say we are capable of protecting our wildlife in this area.
Okay. Do you have rhinos in the park?
No. Rhinos, we don't have them here. We have rhinos in Ziwa.
Okay.
And there are plans to take them to the parks now.
Okay.
The number has increased, and any time that now population will now be taken into the parks.
Because I heard they had a product which is very, very useful. Is it true? The horns. I heard the horns.
Yeah, those are the things that make them to be easily killed. People believe, I think the Asian countries, they believe that it's an aphrodisiac. So the demand for their horn has been high, and that's what all causes their killing. And like for the elephant, it is the tusk that would call the ivory. Those are the things why they are in demand.
So is there any advice you would like to give
to the locals?
Yeah.
I would say this is our God-given resource. Let us protect it. For the tourists, it's a medley of wonders. When you are here, you will enjoy yourself to the best.
And we
have competent guides who will take you to all sites of interest. This is one of the areas you should not avoid.
Yeah.
You should see before you die. I think I was lucky to be to be working here. I used to pass here. I did not know what was really here. But I'm very happy. I'm in here. It has given me a good understanding of what we really have.
Yeah.
The beauty is immense. So I welcome all of you globally. Come and see your God created the resource here. It is splendid.
Yeah, they will say this and they will respond to it.
Yes.
So thank you so much, sir. Yeah, this is Alan, corresponding for East Africa Diplomatic Times. It was nice meeting you.
Okay, thank you.